From News 8 WMTW-TV, this is a News 8 Now update.
Good morning and welcome back to News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. Four York County corrections officers are now on paid administrative leave. Indictments were handed down Thursday to Roger Saleri, John Sibia, Daniel Roy, and Michael Pitts. All four face multiple charges, including assault. The sheriff can't comment on exactly what happened, but did say the alleged incident occurred in April when a former inmate, Jason Robertson, had to be removed from a cell and put into a restraining chair. The sheriff says he's called for an internal review of policies and procedures.
For instance, you know, unfortunately, we're all human beings, and sometimes we all reach a particular point where things happen. And, you know, I don't say that as an excuse or anything, but I just say that we're all human beings, and, you know, we can't turn the clock back to fix what happened back then, but we can certainly move ahead forward, and that's what we're doing in this particular case.
We reached out to the York County District Attorney today. She said she cannot comment on a pending case. Our attempts to reach the four officers were unsuccessful. The state fire marshal's office says a young man killed in Thursday's fire that destroyed a church in Winterport intentionally set the fire to the building and to himself. Fire investigators say 20-year-old Wilbur Strout broke into the Calvary Apostolic Church through a back window, spread a flammable liquid throughout the worship area and in front of the altar, doused himself, and then lit the fire. Investigators say Strout then jumped from a second-floor window and badly burned his body, which was found laying on the ground. Investigators say a series of rambling writings in a journal along with his Bible were found in his car parked in the church's parking lot. Changes in state revenue projections, health care costs, and some other policy decisions mean the state has yet another budget hole to try and fill. This time, it's $164 million that the Maine legislature will need to come up with in order to balance the budget. The debate will likely revolve around two areas. One has to do with Medicaid cuts. The other is the elimination of public funding for gubernatorial candidates. Democrats believe the proposals signal a major policy shift and believe they necessitate further debate. Some Republicans say the new budget will not be rubber stamped.
There are changes that are proposed that the public needs to have a chance to weigh in on.
I'm trying to be as supportive as I can to the governor, but also I have a large caucus of people I need to get to and talk about these things.
One of the reasons the state needs to come up with more money is because the administration has revised some of its original proposals to the state retirement system. Still, the state employees union says too much of the overall budget is being balanced on the backs of state workers. On the heels of last year's record-shattering Maine lobster catch, another big harvest is expected this year. But lobstermen say the outlook for the upcoming season is being shadowed by high fuel costs, high bait costs, and a still fragile economy. Maine fishermen last year caught more than 93 million pounds of lobster, breaking the previous record of 81 million pounds the year before. Even though the resource is strong, lobstermen are cautious that they begin setting and hauling traps as the season starts to get underway. Thanks for joining us here on News 8 Now. I'm Tracy Sable. We'll be right back.